It's gonna be a dark picture.
Okay. You can leave this on. Yeah.
One light is okay. Yeah. All right. So I introduced myself briefly to everyone. My name's TRUE ALISANDRE. I've been into yoga since the 70s when it captured me in South Dade County, the University of Miami. Had a yogi that came from India and gave this incredibly powerful talk. Out of 200 people, about 60 people wanted to learn meditation. Just to emphasize to myself and us here, yoga came to the West first as a meditation practice. It wasn't all the little fancy exercises and straps and mats and all that clothing. But, you know, we do trademark stuff over here. We're branded, you know, so it's got all kinds of brands. And we will do some yoga stretching and breathing. I want to encourage us to take note of this little flyer with a set of lungs on either side, and it says no taking deep breaths. For tonight, if you could just practice letting the breath out, and on the inhale, it'll take care of itself. Most of the time when we just suck it in, we're tightening everything up and we're not de-stressing ourselves. And so here, I have a little laminated card that I'm going to go through at the beginning. The three-way neck stretch, done with 6,000 or more people. There's three YouTube videos of it. If you find that after we did that, oh, I want to remember that, I'll send it to your email. And there's a couple little small business-sized cards of the three-way neck stretch. Over here, I believe I was telling one of the two ladies here that we're going to be working with and playing around with spinal vertebrae when we do yoga stretching and breathing. What is so incredibly beneficial that in between all these vertebrae are intervertebral muscles. We're going to loosen up the small muscles as well as the big jaw muscles like the biceps, triceps, gastrocnemius, quads. In a workout in a gym, that's mostly what we're dealing with, is big muscle showy stuff. Not to be judgmental about it, but they're not paying attention to some of the smaller, finely tuned muscles. So this is to remind us of that. There's a few of those over there. And this accentuates the double exhale or exhale focused breathing. This is from a yoga journal article of all things, and it just hit me between the eyes. The 2-to-1 exhale to inhale ratio. Several medical people are advising that too, and there's copies of this over there, I believe, or an accompanying article. And at some point, if it feels right, TRUE has one copyrighted song in his career, The Intimate Without Breath. I wrote it for myself when I was suffering from a disease called codependency, where I'm trying to validate myself out there instead of in here. Okay, and then this is a nice little simple breathing meditation practice. And I have the mantra that I first practiced meditation with laminated over there with a little step that we can go through. I'm going to see if it feels right for us to use that, or we might do something more generic. But we will do meditation after we do it. Yoga breathing, stretching, the relaxation pose. During the yoga poses, pause and play the bones to you to let you feel some of the benefits of it, and then only during the meditation time and the relaxation time. And that is a quartzophone over there. This is a harp. I will use these two instruments to sort of sonically serenade. So anybody have any questions what we're doing here?
Okay, so you said the exhale to inhale 2-to-1 ratio.
Yes. And the way it's advised on one of the handouts over there, it says, take a breather. It's a little sidebar in the corner of it. It says, breathe into a count of four. So we can try that now. Just hold it for 7. You can maybe put your hands over your heart. Feel the heart beating that fresh new oxygen and energy. Then exhale to a count of 8. The sigh of relief can help with that. Feel your abs tighten quite a bit, close the backbone. Feel the pause after you've exhaled, and then gradually into that vacuum, the new four-count in-breath will come. And I've given it an acronym, TIE, the Incredible Exhale. And it's equivalent to take it easy, people. So to begin with, let's just open up with that little three-way neck stretch I mentioned and the double exhale. We're sitting this or cross-legged, however you like. Noticing our head just gently up there on our shoulders, not locked in place. We can weave a little bit side to side. Is anyone not okay that I sometimes sing the instructions? Is that fine? It just happens, so I don't want to sound weird to anybody if that's what I'm singing for you.
Okay.
You can be wherever you feel comfortable here. I've been tested for COVID too about 10 or 12 times, so I'm limited. Yeah. My girlfriend's immunocompromised, just in case you have that concern. Alright, so we're sitting cross-legged. The palms can be up on our knees or folded in our lap. So we're going to let a four count breath come in through the nostrils, preferably. Like I said, you can hold your hands over your heart, honor your heart beating, circulating that energy. Then exhale through the mouth, a count of eight. Your lungs empty. Receive a new breath of fresh air. This exhale, we're going to drop our chin to our chest, breathing out fully. Imagine, if you would, a picture of health that is you right at this moment in time. Inhale, we're going to let that picture of our healthy self go to all our cells, head coming over our shoulders. Now with me, we're going to exhale and tilt our chin and head to our left shoulder, exhaling. If you might send away any past thoughts that might be troubling or stressful, you might. Inhale, we're going to let our head float back between our shoulders, and we're calling this our present time frame right here and now. Breathing out, we're going to tilt and turn our chin and head towards our right shoulder. Letting go of anything in the future, just for now. Inhaling, we're letting our head float back between our two shoulders. And we're going to just sit for maybe 10 or 15 seconds. Feel this moment with our body, mind, and spirit. Stretch it up toward the ceiling. I want us to notice that on our in-breath, we're stretching our muscles and joints, and now we're going to exhale, let the wrist go, elbow and shoulder, and down to the side. Inhale, stretch the right arm out to the side, palm on the mat. Inhale, up goes the left arm, and we're going to try to keep our left hip pushed into our mat as we reach our left hand over our head to the right. And our trunk and our head's going to drop to all the way back up with the left arm, and our arms stand parallel. Right arm up, and we're going to bend over to the left. Put that left hand out to the side, right hip pressing back. It's parallel. Now we're going to do a beautiful everyday pose we might consider doing, a spinal twist. Right hand to the left shoulder. Left hand, let's just place it right behind our hips, pushing into our mat and lifting ourselves up nice and tall. Back to the front. Hands parallel out to the side. Twisting to the right, left hand to the right shoulder. And that right hand right behind our hips, looking over our right shoulder. We're trying to, if we can, not lean back to get that twist. Just go as far as we comfortably can. And back to the front. And now, both arms up. A nice stretch. A nice inhale. Exhale, folding forward. Palms landing on the mat. Forearms. Then we're going to maybe wiggle at the pelvis and waist. Notch yourself down. Not feeling pain, but just moving up to the edge of our tightness. Coming all the way back up. Let's twist over to that left again. With one hand in front, one hand behind. Inhale back to the front, hands on the mat, fingertips above. Over to the right. And back to the front. And we're going to go through that sequence one more time. Connect it all together. Bending those side muscles to the left. Every now and then smile if you're grimacing like I just have been. All the way up to the right arm down, left arm up, over to the right. It's parallel. This time we're going to give ourselves a little twisting hug. Just wrap your arms around your trunk. Give yourself a twisting hug. And unwind from that. Twist your hugging self to the right. And back to the front. One more time. This time, let's see if we can interlock the fingers. Bring those elbows close to our ears. Forward. See if you notice your fingers, trunk, folding a little more in this second repetition. And as we come back up, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to now lift or lean back. Pelvis coming up, the hips off the mat. If you can't lean back, I mean lift back, you can lean back. So now I want you to close your eyes for 30 seconds. Let me play these balls to you. I want you to feel those parts of your body that you just stretched and moved. And be grateful for them loosening up. Let's come up to the all four positions. It's called the cat and cow. We may eliminate the downward dog since I heard some difficulties and uncomplimentary comments about it. But I often do the cat and cow and child pose, play in an up dog, down dog. We'll see how it feels. We're going to breathe out first, ladies and gentlemen. Pull the ab muscles and belly in towards the backbone, emptying the lungs, head between the arms. Now let's first just curl our head and neck up as we inhale. Then we're going to push our tailbone and hips out, trying to feel that low back curve. And dropping our hips back onto our heels, child pose. And breathe in nicely, feeling the spine stretch and the ribs open up. Back up to that cat and cow position. Exhale. Push the eyes as much as you can. in. We're gonna this time see if we can do head and neck and tailbone at the same time. Breathe in, head and neck up, tailbone out. And go. Hips back on the heels. This time let's put the hands back, palms up. And we're gonna go with one more of those. This time we're gonna stretch an arm and leg and see how balancing we can be. Breath out, arching up. And now the right arm off the mat. And if we can keep our balance, left leg, opposite arm and leg. And release that. Now see if our right arm will thread under the left arm. And we're gonna lay on the right side of our head. And if it's not painful, let's take that left arm, reach or lay it behind our back. Unwinding the left arm, pulling the right arm back through. Lifting up, pulling the ab muscles in, and emptying the lungs. Now let's see if we can do it at the same time. Left arm and right leg. Reach out, point the toes and fingers if you like. And bring it down. Now the left arm threads under the right arm. And if we want to and can, wrap the right arm. Unwrapping that right arm, pulling that left arm back through, dropping into the child pose. And let's have a couple of really beautiful full breaths. Remember the incredible exhale part. And receive some breaths of fresh air. Truly's gonna serenade you once again. At the low back, only if you feel really loose this way, drop down and grab the ankles if you want. And here we go. We're going to come out of that and we're going to bring the feet forward, sit in a perpendicular upright position. So let's get our centeredness in this staff pose, it's called. It's kind of like a pivotal yoga pose for which we do a lot of other things. Bring the arms up over the head. Try to keep the feet upright if you can. Fold forward. We're going to see where our fingers touch, the ankles or maybe the calves, or even under the calf muscles. Fold forward. Inhale, come back upright. We're going to open these feet about hip width apart. This is again another one of the positions where we might just lean back, but if we have the willingness to give it a try or the strength, we can lift the thighs and the belly and the back into a bridge pose. Try and open the feet up a little more if it's difficult. Yeah, open your feet up just a little bit more than that. Get all the way back down, hips on the mat. This is another one of those challenging yoga poses called boat. Lift the legs off the mat. If you need to hold under the knees, that's okay. Let's open the legs. Fold forward again. All the way toward the mat. Inhale back upright. We're going to touch our feet together. And do a little butterfly with the shoulders down, fanning those legs toward the mat. Okay, giving it one more round. Nice legs long. This is called head to knee pose. Very creatively named because our head's going to bend towards our knees. Arms up first. Breathing out and exhale. See if you might be able to notice you can reach maybe a little further down your feet on this second one. Inhale, coming back up. I'm going to give you an option too. If you want to, instead of the full bridge, you can lay the torso like this and just come up like that for a half bridge. Whatever works for you. Lift up. Here's where we're stretching that spine. We just collapsed it and bent it in the previous one. And all the way back down, landing on those hips. Legs coming out. You can keep them in the same bend we had before, or you can sit back in it a little further. Even our hands over the head. And then open the legs and fold forward again. Okay, all the way back upright. So here's where I want us all to, not me, but y'all, lay in the relaxation pose, hands out to the side, palms up, legs a little more than hip width. And one of my students in Mountain Home once said, coming in for an afternoon class, "True, can we not just lay in relaxation pose and call it a class?" I said, "Well, it doesn't work like that." It was a nice try, though, to get really just relaxation right from the very beginning. This time, I'm going to come around to y'all playing a little device called a quartzophone. Just you focus in like a breathing. Thank you. meditation approach. So let's come up to the cat-cow as a way to start coming into an upright standing position. So we're going to breathe out, arch the back up. Inhale, curl the head and neck up. Lengthen the legs into the push-up-like position called plank. Toes stretching up to the downward dog very briefly. Then we're going to bring our right foot forward under our right knee for a lunge position. Then we're going to bring our left foot next to our right foot and do my unfavorite yoga pose, the chair. And all the way up to standing. Okay. All right. So let's try a little sequence that is on one of my little cards over there, the Warrior Triangle. And any of the ones that we've done so far could be your whole yoga practice for that day. You know, the seated cross-legged set, the hare and camel, or the cat-cow, chow pose, any of those. Okay, so we're going to try to double the width of our legs to our shoulders. So shoulder width, it's like this. We're going to try to make 1.5 or 2 shoulder widths. And face towards our left foot. And we're going to drop and stretch this right knee over that right foot. At the same time, we're trying to lengthen that back leg. Inhale, bring those arms up as much as we can alongside our ears. That's what we call a warrior one. So Emily, face this way towards your foot bit. Face it like this. There you go. And now we're going to exhale and do a little twist with the torso parallel to the arms. Shoulders dropping nicely down. And then this right arm slides down the back leg. That was warrior two. This is called the reverse warrior. That left arm reaching up, that right arm down the back leg. And this is the most fabulous part for me. We're going to bring our left arm down and our back leg forward. And oftentimes, you lose your balance doing that, but it's really wonderful to feel the body just move through space. So now we're going to have the right foot out, the left foot angled, knee over ankle. Arms hanging loosely right now. Up this way, and I'm in on these arms. Alongside that leg, up there, warrior. Inhaling. We can look up to if we want. Now we're going to drop the right arm and the left arm parallel to the floor. Left arm down the back leg as we inhale, right arm up. And when we do this beautiful exhale, hopefully I stay more balanced than before. The right arm comes down and this back leg comes forward. So then you feel that, like that flow of that, you know, coming into balance. It just, it's flowing over. I noticed that after about 30 or 40 years of yoga. Right foot out, left foot. We're going to do one more sequence. Arms over our head, breathing in. And more importantly, exhaling parallel the arms.